Hey guys, it's Layla. Welcome back to my channel. In today's video, I'm going to be giving a review of the new e.l.f. Cosmetics, the Big Mood Mega Volume and Lifting Mascara. This is the newest mascara from the e.l.f. Cosmetics line. As you can tell, it's got this really bright metallic purple packaging and it's very eye-catching. I've actually tried this mascara several times before recording today's video because I really wanted to give a very accurate, honest review of this new mascara. A lot of times I will try a product for the first time and I might hate it, but after trying it a few more times, I end up liking it, it grows on me. So I've tried it a couple times in heat and humidity. I'm gonna do a little demonstration today. I'm gonna put it on camera, show you what it looks like, and I'm gonna give you my full review. So if that sounds good, stick around and keep watching. So I purchased this mascara from Target for $7 before tax. They did have a two-pack and the two-pack was $13, so it was a dollar savings, but I wasn't gonna buy a two-pack unless I tried the mascara first. I really need to make sure that I like it before I buy it in bulk. So if it is something that you wanna try, someone else you know wants to try, or you just wanna buy in bulk, just know that there's about a dollar savings and that you can purchase it in a two-pack. So $7 is very reasonable for drugstore mascara, especially when counter mascara can run you upwards of $30 or more. So I thought that the price is very reasonable. You know, it's a vegan product, which is awesome. It's cruelty-free and vegan. It says that it's dramatically volumizing, lengthening, and lifting. It's clean and vegan formula. It's infused with jojoba oil, and it leaves the lashes feeling nourished. It's got an hourglass brush with 250 intertwined bristles to lift and separate lashes, creating an intense, bigger and bolder look. So it's got staying power and, you know, I read this description. First things first, it is a very, very creamy formula. So that part is true. It is very quick drying. That's something to keep in mind. My lid area is very small. I've said that in other videos as well, which is very true. So a lot of times with the brush, I end up hitting my my lid area, and I have to go back and clean it up afterwards. But with the Big Mood mascara, it ends up drying so quickly that cleaning up the eye area is very difficult. So I don't even bother trying to do it immediately because it just dries so quickly and creates such a mess when I do it with a Q-tip. So I go back and do it afterwards. So you might see that on camera, but I'm gonna demo it for you guys to see what I'm talking about. So I'm gonna start with my left eye and then work on my right eye. I'm gonna do two coats on each lash. First things first, when I take the brush out of the mascara case, it doesn't pick up a lot of excess product. With a lot of mascaras, that happens immediately, but I don't end up having to wipe excess off. It picks up a little bit of excess, but not too much, which I actually really, really like that. So that's something that I noticed immediately. They are not kidding around. The wand is absolutely, it's got a ton of those bristles, the 250 bristles. I end up really liking brushes that have an hourglass shape. That ends up in the past, from the brushes that I've used before, the ones with the hourglass shape work out really well for me. I do really like those. So when I saw the brush shape, I was really excited too, because I do love that. So I'm gonna go in and work it through my lashes. The thing that I notice immediately is that it hugs the lash really well. As you can tell, I've already got it on my lid area. So this is what it looks like after one coat. Now I'm gonna go in with the second coat. It's important to do this pretty quickly so that the mascara, like I said, it's a very quick drying formula. So if you put the second coat on and take too long to do it, it will get clumpy. So try to do it pretty quickly after you do the first coat. It's kind of hard to separate with this brush, and I also feel like See, like it already has dried down so quickly. This was my problem earlier too. So it kind of clumps the lashes together. So you really have to work it very, you really have to work this brush to get it to separate them. So it's kind of a clumpy mess right now because, again, it is so quick drying. Can you guys see that? So it just clumps them together because if you don't just apply right away, it's just a hot mess. So it is probably the jojoba oil, which makes it so thick, and it gives it staying power. But it's also very annoying in when you try to define them or just do the second coat, really clean it up. So I just don't love this formula. I just do not love how quickly it dries. Can you guys see that? How clumpy it is right now? Like half of my lashes are clumped together, and this is the problem that I've had every single time. So right now my left side looks like a hot clumpy mess. But I'm gonna go in with the right side and I'm just gonna, put the second coat on even quicker. So I also just feel like it does not separate the lashes as well as it advertises, and it is not as volumizing. And I'm gonna go in with the second coat very, very quickly. Okay, so this is what it looks like right now with two coats on each eye. So typically after I apply the Big Mood mascara on each lash, I'll go in with a makeup remover and I'll wipe off any excess that I got on my lid or lower lash line, and then I apply concealer over it to kind of cover up those smudge or marks or that darkness. And I have tried this on some really hot, muggy and humid days in Massachusetts recently. And to be honest with you, as far as how it wears, I did get flaking, both on my lid and lower lash line throughout the day. So I wore this for 8 to 10 hours and it definitely smudged, it definitely flaked. I didn't necessarily get the raccoon eyes, but there was almost like a dark shadow underneath my eye. So I just didn't think that the Big Mood held up as well as maybe it would indoors on a cooler day. I tested this out in the most extreme circumstances, and it stays in place on your lash, but it definitely smudges and flakes. So that's just something to keep in mind. Again, if you work in an office setting, if you're in air conditioning, if you're only going to be running out for a little bit, I think that this will work out. But as far as how it's going to fare in really hot, muggy, summer, humid days, I don't think it's going to do as well. The L'Oreal Lash Paradise and the Maybelline Sky High Mascara both do a much better job, in my opinion. I'm actually surprised that this was like a summer rollout because I just don't think that this is a summer product. I also don't think that it really volumizes or separates the lashes as well as advertised because it just dries down too quickly. Yes, it's a creamy formula, but it just dries down too quickly, honestly. And so it's very hard to work with this and just really separate the lashes. I do like that the brush hugs the lash line really nicely, but it's just too hard to work with. Again, it's just too quick drying. And then when you want to apply your second coat, you really have to work through it. And then you can't even apply more coats to really kind of work through them because it's already dried and then it clumps, as you saw. So overall, the Big Mood mascara was not my favorite, but I'm glad that I got to try it, and I hope that this video helped answer some questions you might have about it. If you have any other questions, feel free to drop them in the comments. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up and subscribe to the channel. Thanks for watching, you guys, and I will see you in the next video.